Houthi rebels claim more attacks in the Red Sea and the Arabian Sea. The militant group says it launched naval missiles and drones on two civilian ships and ballistic missiles on an American destroyer. It was not clear whether any of the targets were hit. Now, early on Sunday, the United Kingdom Maritime Trade Operations said a vessel had reported two explosions. It added the vessel and its crew are safe and continuing their journey without identifying the ship. The Iran-aligned Houthis have launched dozens of attacks on international shipping in the Red Sea region since November in solidarity with Palestinians in Gaza. President Ferdinand Marcos calls on Filipino Muslims to be courageous, even at the expense of comfort and security. In his message for Eid al-Adha, Marcos urged the public to grow in wisdom and fortitude amid challenges. He noted the occasion is a reminder that there is a gain in surrender and the act of letting go. In a separate statement, Vice President Sara Duterte also commemorated the feast, expressing hope Filipinos would remember the value of sacrifice and gratitude on this day. Leaders of Transport Group Manibela facing more criminal charges. The Quezon City Police District says Manibela National President Mar Valbuena and other members of the group will be charged with physical injuries. This stems from accusations some Manibela members hit a radio reporter during their three-day protest last week. The new charge is on top of the alarm and scandal and resistance and disobedience cases filed against the group. Valbuena, for his part, slams the Quezon City Police, calling them liars.
Sana po magsabi tayo ng totoo kasi nakalagay po doon, false po ito eh. Kung may disobedience o resistance po na nangyari, sana hinuli na po kami nila ng mga oras na yon o nung araw na yon. Inaamin naman namin na yung oras po na nagmarcha kami papuntang LTFRB, hindi din namin inaasahan na ganun po kadami yung tutugon o tumugon doon sa panawagan ng Pilos Protesta. Kung makikita natin, talagang nasarahan po yung isang bahagi ng East Avenue. Okay. Pero sandali lang po yon. Sa akin po ay gawa-gawa po eh. Maayos po kami, magkakaibigan po kami doon, nagkukwentuhan kami, at sinasabi kung ano yung mga gagawin namin.
Last week's rollback, just a temporary respite. Fuel prices headed higher again this week. Pilipinas Shell has announced diesel will be going up by 1 peso and 75 centavos per liter and gasoline by 85 centavos. Kerosene seeing the biggest jump of 1 peso and 90 centavos per liter. The price movement already factors in premium, freight, and ethanol adjustments. Remittances sent by Filipinos abroad rise in April. Data from the Philippine Central Bank showed personal remittances reached $2.86 billion in April. That is a 3.1% increase from the 2.7% or $7 billion recorded in the same period last year. Year-to-date, cash remittances have so far reached $10.78 billion. The growth in April was mainly driven by remittances from the U.S., Saudi Arabia, and Singapore. At least 14 Jordanian citizens have died during the Hajj pilgrimage in Saudi Arabia due to intense heat. Jordan's foreign ministry said 17 other pilgrims have been reported missing. The Iranian Red Crescent also confirming five Iranian pilgrims had lost their lives. Hajj is one of the largest mass gatherings in the world with 1.8 million Muslims taking part this year. Temperatures exceeded 46 degrees Celsius last week in Mecca and Medina, the two cities at the heart of the five-day pilgrimage.